Hey, I'm John with EOTECH, and I want to talk to you a little bit about some of the new products that EOTECH's got coming out for 2020. First being an extension of the magnifier line. So for years, EOTECH has had the G33 magnifier in their line. This is the magnifier that is included with the US SOCOM contract. EOTECH provides holographic weapon sights and the G33 magnifier to our tip of the spear warriors and special forces. G33 is a 3X magnifier. Features flip-out capabilities, it's got a quick-detach mount, super rugged built, just an excellent magnifier all around. For 2020, EOTECH has added three additional magnifiers to their magnifier line. The first being the G43. The G43, and that there, is a, as you can see, a miniaturized 3X magnifier. This is roughly half the length of the existing G33, still has the flip out capability, quick detach mount, same optical qualities that is that of the G33 is known for, but just in a more miniaturized version. Tool-free adjustments, all the bells and whistles. From there, we go to the G45. The G45 is a 5X magnifier. Again, flip out capability, quick detach mount, toolless adjustments, excellent optical quality. Dimensions-wise, we're looking at roughly the same size as the existing G33, maybe a tad heavier, but not noticeable. And you get that extra 2X magnification out of it. The third new magnifier is called the G30. The G30 is a more kind of budget-friendly 3X magnifier. It's very similar to the G33, the existing magnifier in the line. However, it lacks the rubber armor on it, and it does not have the flip-out capabilities, but as you can see, it still does have the quick-detach mount there. This will retail for about half the price of the existing G33, so people can get into a very high-quality magnifier. Again, same optical quality as the G33, but for about half the price, so coming in around $300 MSRP. So a ton of value there. One of the things I want to talk about a little bit with in terms of the magnifiers is with a EOTECH holographic weapon sight, the difference between that and your standard red dot sight is that the reticle that you see in a holographic weapon sight is produced by a laser diode instead of a light emitting diode or an LED, which is what produces the aiming point in a standard red dot sight. And there are a number of inherent advantages behind a holographic sight. One being that the center dot in the middle of your EOTECH reticle, and a lot of people are familiar with that, it's got the speed ring around the outside, 68 MOA, and then a 1 MOA center dot in there. With a standard red dot sight, if you put a magnifier behind that, that 1 MOA dot in a red dot sight is going to grow in magnification. Not so with a holographic weapon sight. The center dot here is actually, in truth, only a few microns in diameter. However, the human eye can only discern down to 1 MOA, so that is how it perceives it. Under magnification, it does not grow even to 1 MOA, and so it is still perceived to be just 1 MOA in size. And it, as such, it does not obscure your target downrange. So when you're looking at a target farther downrange with additional magnification, you can know that that center dot is not going to obscure your target in any way with a holographic reticle sight reticle, a holographic weapon sight reticle. These new magnifiers are going to be available this coming spring. The G43 and G45 will be available this spring. The G30 here is available right now. You can check them out at eotechgear.com, online retailers, and your favorite retail locations. In 2016, EOTECH launched the Vudu line of rifle scopes. These are extremely rugged-built precision rifle scopes in a number of configurations, from 1 to 6 by 24 at the low end, up to an 8 to 32 by 50 kind of F-class scope at the high end, everything in between, 3.5 to 18, 2.5 to 10, 5 to 25 by 50, something for everybody. Until 2020, the 1 to 6 by 24, which is a first focal plane scope, was the only LPVO offering. For 2020, we've got a 1 to 8 by 24. This is a second focal plane offering in the Vudu line. One of the things that some of the competition guys were noticing with the 1 to 6 by 24 is that the red reticle in that scope under really bright daylight conditions was kind of hard to pick up from time to time. So in going to a second focal plane configuration here, we're able to integrate a daylight visible center dot in the reticle that is visible under any lighting conditions, whether bright daylight, dark overcast, you name it. This thing will get you on target really fast. Check them out at voodooptics.com. When we talk about the EOTECH advantage, and by that we mean the advantages that a holographic weapon sight has over a standard red dot sight, there are several tenets to that. The first being speed to target. With the reticle produced by a laser diode being a holographic reticle, the human eye is able to perceive the reticle as being on the same plane as your target. With a red dot sight, you have to either consciously or subconsciously shift your focus back and forth between your aiming point and whatever you're aiming at. Not so with a holographic reticle. It appears to be on the same focal plane as the target, and so you're able to get on target faster and engage sooner. Obviously, EOTECH is well known for its large field of view, its large window. That encourages, two eye open operation, which increases peripheral vision and situational awareness. The reticle in a holographic weapon sight, which has become very ubiquitous and well known to people, it's got the 68 MOA speed ring around a very precise and crisp 1 MOA center dot. The idea behind that reticle is the ring helps you get on target fast at close range, and that center dot, that 1 MOA center dot, allows for precision aiming at distance. And even with a magnifier behind a holographic weapon sight, that center dot will not grow in size. That dot is in fact only several microns in diameter. The human eye, however, can only discern down to 1 MOA, so it appears as 1 MOA without magnification and with magnification, because even with a 5x magnifier or 3x magnifier behind it, it will not grow past 1 MOA. So you're still getting a very precise and crisp aiming point for extended ranges on targets that are 200, 250 yards down range. To kind of build on the EOTECH advantage a little bit, one of the other really cool features about a holographic weapon sight is this front window. With a standard red dot sight, the aiming point is reflected off the objective lens and back to the user. With a holographic weapon sight, there's a whole series of different gratings and mirrors in here, and that front window truly is there just to seal off the optic. It is not used in any way to project the reticle back to the user. As such, if that front window is to become compromised, say it gets cracked in use, gets covered in mud or whatever else, as long as there is some portion of that window visible to the user, the reticle will show up. So that allows for off-axis shooting. It allows for shooting under duress if that front window is to become compromised. Those are just a few of the things that go into what we call the EOTECH advantage here, and that kind of separate a holographic weapon sight from a standard red dot.
If you like this video and want to support us, please check out the MIL-SPEC Monkey Store. Although known for morale patches, we also specialize in a good selection of DIY hardware and tactical accessories.